In this video, I'll walk you through the process of implementing versioning in an ASP.NET Core Web API. By the end of this video, you'll learn how to update your ASP.NET Core Web API smoothly without breaking existing apps. You can access the source code from our Patreon. The link is in the description. So let's dive in. First, let's install the necessary libraries. To begin, I'm installing asp.versioning.mvc. Next, let's also install asp.versioning.mvc.ApiExplorer. In our project, we already have a controller named weatherForecastController, which contains a get method that returns some dummy weather data. Now, let's organize our project by creating a folder for version 1 and moving this controller inside it. Next, we'll modify the road template to include the version number. I'll show you how this works shortly. Additionally, I'm adding an attribute named API version and assigning the version number as 1. Now, let's create copies of this folder and name them version 2 and version 3. We'll also update the controller namespace accordingly. Finally, let's modify the API version attribute in each controller to reflect the correct version number. To make it easier to track which version is being executed, I'll update the response of the get method to include a message displaying the version number. Next, let's move to the program.cs file and inject the necessary dependencies. First, we'll add the API versioning dependency and configure a few options. We'll set assume default version when unspecified to true, so that if no version is specified, the application will execute the default method. Then we'll define the default API version as 1.0. Let's also enable report API versions by setting it to true. This ensures that the response headers will include the supported versions. Now, we also need to add MVC and configure version by namespace convention, which allows us to version controllers based on their namespace. Finally, we'll enable API Explorer, which helps in API metadata discovery. This is particularly useful for tools like Swagger, which I'll demonstrate later in this video. Now, let's test our API using Postman. First, let's execute version 1. As expected, we received a response and the message includes the same version number we executed. We can also specify the version number as just 1 and the same method will be executed. Now, let's test version 2. This time, you'll notice that the message has changed, indicating that the get method from the second controller was executed. Finally, let's try version 3. As you can see, this triggers the method in the third controller. So far, we've been specifying the API version in the URL, but there are other ways to do this. To demonstrate, let's first assign an additional route template without a version number. I'll apply this same template across all three controllers. Next, we need to configure the API version reader in the program class. Before showing you these in action, let me first explain the different ways we can read the API version from a request. We can pass the version number as a query parameter. To enable this, we need to specify the parameter name. The API version can also be provided using a custom request header by defining its name. If needed, we can extract the API version from the media type in the request. If we want to support multiple options simultaneously, we can combine these methods to allow versioning through query strings, headers, and media types all at once. Now, let's see how we can provide the version numbers in different ways. First, I'm using the new URL without a version number. Since we've set version 1 as the default, this request will hit the version 1 controller. Now, let's try passing the version number as a query string. As you can see, the response message confirms that version 2 got executed. Let's change the version number to 3 and try again. This time, the message indicates that version 3 was executed. Next, let's test providing the version number in the request header. Make sure to use the same header name that we configured in the program.cs file. This request executed the version 2 method. Now, let's specify the version number in the content type header. As expected, it executed the exact version method. Let's try again with version 3, and you can see it works as expected. I hope you are clear with the API version reader configuration. I've also configured Swagger in our demo project. Swagger displays all the available API versions along with their corresponding URLs. We can directly execute a URL with the version included and check the response. If we change the version, Swagger will automatically update the version in the URL as well. For example, you can see that the message now includes version 2. If you'd like to explore the Swagger implementation, you can check out the source code on Patreon. I've included all the Swagger configuration classes here for reference. The Patreon link is available in the description. That's it for this video. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video. Thank you.